The Honor Band 5 has been out for just over a year now, and with the Honor Band 6 on the horizon, I thought I'd pick one up and do an updated review and unboxing for you. I did, however, buy this primarily to do a Galaxy Fit 2 comparison video, and that video will drop later on in the week. So let's take a look at the good, the bad, and indeed the ugly with the Honor Band 5. Hello everyone, welcome back to Tech It Easy. So the Honor Band 5 is on the review table today, and I've got to say, first impressions for a device that's a year behind the Galaxy Fit 2, I'm really, really impressed and pleasantly surprised. First thing I'm noticing is that squarer, sharper AMOLED display. I much prefer it to the likes of the Galaxy Fit 2 and the Xiaomi Mi Band 5. You can actually see the screen is actually curved slightly, whilst the Mi Band 5 and Galaxy Fit 2 are flat and don't really follow the curvature of your wrist quite as well. Next thing I'm noticing is the included strap. It has a really nice textured finish, and again, it feels much more sturdy than both the Xiaomi Mi Band 5 and the Galaxy Fit 2. But I'm going to save any more comparisons for another video, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out on that. So let's take a look at the Honor Band 5 and how it comes to you and jump into a quick unboxing. So the packaging is pretty standard, it looks nice, it's nothing premium though, nor would I expect it to be for such a low price of just $27.99 on Amazon, or roughly $37 if you're in the US. There will be links in the description to check out the latest prices. So as I mentioned at the start of the video, first impressions of the build quality were excellent. It felt like a device that should cost a lot more. But then my heart sank as I pulled out the same charger I hated so much on the Galaxy Fit 2. It's fiddly and it's not easy to attach and detach in a hurry. So I'm hoping they'll switch that up when the Honor Band 6 releases. Perhaps they could do something like Xiaomi did on the Mi Band 5, which was actually one of the only things I particularly loved about that fitness band. Anyway, other than the included charger and the Honor Band 5 itself, there really isn't much else inside the box other than a few booklets. There is, however, a super satisfying sticker to peel off the screen. So now the unboxing's out of the way, let's talk about some of the important specs, the first stop being the battery life. Now, Huawei say that you will get 14 days of battery life out of the Honor Band 5, and I can definitely see that being true. I've had this about a week, didn't charge it all the way up to 100%, and it's lost roughly 30%. Admittedly, there was a day and a half where I wasn't wearing it, but still, it's given me a pretty good idea of what it's capable of. Now, battery life will of course depend on usage. So if you're using it for sleep tracking, continuous heart rate monitoring all day, every day, with the screen brightness whacked all the way up to the max, then don't expect the 14 days Huawei state. Nonetheless, if you were doing all those things, I'd imagine you'd get a solid week out of it at the absolute minimum, which is still plenty for most. Next, I want to quickly flip back to that display. Now, there's a lot to love about the Honor Band 5's display. It's crisp, it's vibrant, and it feels pretty big to be on a fitness band. It is, of course, a touchscreen, which is where the Honor Band 5 does let itself down a little bit. I found the touch sensitivity to be a little bit inconsistent, and you really have to exaggerate your swipes when browsing through the UI. Many times it's recognized a swipe to be a tap, and I've ended up going into the app I didn't really want to visit. Not a huge drawback, but it can be frustrating, and more so when you're running or exercising. Now, the Honor Band 5 is not a smartwatch, but it does have some elements of a smartwatch that people have grown to love, such as the ability to switch your watch face out. It comes with a few different options already installed as stock. They're all pretty vibrant and complement the screen nicely. Personalization is certainly a nice touch to have on a device like this. Next up, we have calls and text notifications. Again, another really nice feature to have. And something I've come to expect from modern fitness trackers in 2020 and indeed 2021. It works well enough, it does what you'd expect it to do. The Honor Band 5 has a built-in vibration motor, so you shouldn't be missing anything important. You of course can't take calls on the band itself, but you can swipe to answer and indeed decline calls on your phone. Additionally to this, we have a few other really useful features, such as the Find My Phone function, as well as a camera shutter controller. I love that features like these, usually seen on much more expensive smartwatches, are coming down to much more affordable fitness trackers. Speaking of useful features, let's talk about tracking and monitoring on the Honor Band 5. First up, heart rate tracking. It works in a very similar way to most other fitness trackers, but I was wondering how accurate it actually was. So I went ahead and took a few readings on both the Galaxy Watch 3 and the Honor Band 5. Each time there's only a few beats different, which is fine as it's perfectly normal for your heart rate to go up and down. So compared to Samsung's flagship smartwatch, it's looking pretty accurate. Now, one huge feature that puts the Honor Band 5 above all the rest is the SpO2 monitoring, or blood oxygen monitoring, something both the Xiaomi Mi Band 5 and Galaxy Fit 2 were lacking. This is an excellent feature to have on a fitness tracker at this price point. As well as this, there's also things like sleep tracking and steps counting, which come as standard on most fitness trackers these days. Just before we round things up, I want to talk about the workout section. Now, unfortunately, this is another area where the Honor Band 5 does fail. It doesn't have nearly as much toys as the Xiaomi Mi Band 5 and the Galaxy Fit 2, but I'll go more in depth on that in the upcoming comparison video, so make sure you're subscribed. It does have a few options such as outdoor running, indoor cycling, swimming, rowing, and a few others. But what it's lacking is specifics, and this is definitely something Huawei can fix in the upcoming Honor Band 6. So what is my overall opinion on the Honor Band 5? Well, to be honest, I'm upset I didn't try this out earlier. It's actually really, really impressed me. I love the screen, I love the overall build quality, I'm impressed that there's the SpO2 monitoring, and I'm a big fan of how budget friendly it is. It's actually tearing me away from the Galaxy Fit 2 a little, but we will discuss that in a future in-depth comparison video. But it's not all singing and dancing for the Honor Band 5 though. It is lacking a few things such as a more detailed workout section, and that touch display definitely needs a little bit of attention. Overall though, I'd highly recommend this over the Xiaomi Mi Band 5 at least, and depending on the price of the Honor Band 6 on release, it might even be worth buying this still over that. But is it still worth buying now? Absolutely. Although a year behind some of its competitors, it still puts up a good fight, with some extremely impressive features for its price bracket. That being said though, it wouldn't hurt to wait for the Honor Band 6 to be released to see if there's any major changes or upgrades. One last thing to mention just before we conclude is that this band is actually waterproof up to a depth of 50 meters, so you can of course take it swimming with you, and you'll obviously be okay if you get caught out in the rain. So that was the Honor Band 5. As always, let me know in the comment section what you thought of it, and please do hit that like button if you enjoyed the video. Also, if you are new around here, please do hit that subscribe button so you don't miss the Galaxy Fit 2 comparison. But for now, thank you so much for watching, and hopefully I will see you in the next one.